We're back. As we said, we have more on the economy tonight. We're beginning a series, Hard Times, a nightly news survival guide with a look at how our economy and financial markets got where they are at this very moment, and further what you can do to protect yourself from what could be the hard times ahead indeed. Here's CNBC's Carl Quintanilla.
Lynn and Dennis Friendly are facing hard times, watching the stock market fall.
Some of the key pounds, we can say.
Pinching pennies in ways not seen since stagflation. That mix of inflation and unemployment from the 70s was a household word.
The crunch that it's put on us financially is very tight.
So what's gone wrong? Two things. The first, you probably guessed, is the price of oil. Up 74% in a year. And a big reason, the cost of gasoline, heating oil, electricity, even groceries and dairy products have soared. The Friendly's heating oil bill has gone from $217 a month to more than $320.
That's a couple thousand dollars a year in your savings. And that's your vacation money.
The other more important reason for the economy's troubles began right here.
Absolutely no closing costs.
Cheap mortgages that convinced Americans anyone could own a home. Those rates were kept low after 9/11 to boost the economy, keep it out of recession. But they also sparked a borrowing binge, igniting the housing sector.
Home ownership rates, the highest ever.
Some Americans couldn't keep up with their payments. Banks, stuck with the bill, stopped lending as much, which means businesses are hiring fewer workers, which means consumers, like the Friendlies, are spending less. Consumer spending drives three-quarters of the economy, and if it dries up, that's trouble.
If consumers lose faith, if they panic and pull back, then you have a bad Christmas season and you can have recession.
Some say the economy will end the year just fine, thanks to foreign consumers who never had a housing crunch and with a weak dollar are coming here and buying American. But even optimists say it will be a tough haul.
So if the economy keeps up like this, I honestly believe there'll be no more middle class. We're a dying breed out here.
We've been pre-approved.
Carl Quintanilla, CNBC, New York.